UK Sports, in association with the PGA Tour, is delighted to present the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the Travellers' Championship is about to begin. I'm Luke Elvey, alongside Rich Beam in the booth. And it's hello to Henny Koyak down on the course, following our featured group.
Hi, Luke and Rich. Looking forward to following these two players again as they reignite their rivalry. I have a feeling we'll be in for some more exciting golf as these two battle it out.
So that's the final word from Beamer. Let's see how this one goes. That's tidy. Playing from around 110 yards out. Choosing the 9-iron here. Oh my, right by the hole. Big time play that one, Beamer.
Almost a gimme birdie there, Luke. Fantastic.
Just a tiny putt is all that remains. Well, that's a nice way to start, writing a little red number down on the scorecard at first.
I've never been disappointed by starting off my round with a birdie, Luke, I can tell you that.
The second, a short par four playing up the hill, just 345 yards.
How aggressive do you want to be? Do you want to take driver out and try and get it up to the front edge, or are you going to lay it back with a long iron? That are the two thoughts that players must face. Second shot into a minuscule green with a putt bunker on the left-hand side that could be the meanest one on the golf course. That dog will hunt.
This putt coming up is for birdie. Hey, that's a chance. And the putt drops, and we're moving on. Now heading over to Xander Schauffele.
He's got some work to do, but he's only one back from his rival.
And that shot goes in. That'll be a birdie. That'll help make a big move. And after that effort, this is how the leaderboard looks. The players will face themselves with their first legitimate test at TPC River Highlands, the par 4 third.
Dogleg from right to left. Just avoid those bunkers both right and left. And there's not a single one up there on that green. This green is fairly flat with runoffs on all sides of this green. It's a wonderful design.
Oh, that was flushed. Do you like the view from where you're standing, Henny?
Setting up from about 130 yards out.
Yeah, that was a safe play. We'll now move over to Xander Schauffele.
Birdied their last hole.
Let's get back to it, shall we? This is one of those lengthy putts. Good one just to get close.
He's staring down a birdie putt here.
Oh, just missed. An opportunity to make their par. And well hold. Let's move on. He's currently tied for seventh. The fourth hole at TPC River Highlands certainly asks for a longer shot, Rich.
Danger here is leaving your tee shot out to the right in the trees and the bunker. If you hit it down the left-hand side, expect a much longer second shot.
Nicely done. And Henny, what are you seeing down there?
Setting up here from about 195 yards.
Opting for the 5-iron.
This one is chewing fiber.
Well, that's well played, and a great birdie opportunity coming up here at the fourth.
Nearly doesn't get any better than that. Amazing shot.
And this putt is to move into the top five. Nice line. Just didn't drop. Just 4 feet remaining between him and the hole. It's half a chance of being holed, this one. That looked good for a long way. Bogey putt coming up here. Trailing by 4 strokes. The par 3 fifth is no snack either, particularly at the distance of 230.
That's its only defense here, Luke. The green is fairly flat, has a couple of bunkers up there surrounding it, but to be fair, at 230 yards, it's a pretty simple, straightforward, long par 3.
Seems to have chosen the 3-wood. Oh, can you believe it?
Oh, happy days ahead. A hole in one. Can you believe it?
Moments like that deserve another viewing. Let's take a look at
that. Was beautiful. I'm chilling, watching the play in, but that was fantastic. Like I had to say something.
To Xander Schauffele.
He's currently ahead in this rivalry. Let's see what happens.
Oh, that's a beauty. Great shot from the bunker. Okay, let's get back to the action. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. The sixth is the first of our par fives, and at 586, playing slightly downhill, Ridge. Players should be enticed to go for this green in two.
Most players in this field will be looking to knock it on in two. Tee shots want to favor the right-hand side to shorten up the hole ever so slightly. The second shot will be semi-blind, taking it over some bunkers and some mounds to a green that runs from right to left. Bunker front left and a runoff area over on the right-hand side. Shouldn't be too much of a bother for most of these players. Yes, the gentle fade, the butter cut, if you will.
Yeah, that one will play. Love coming to TPC River Highlands every year, Rich. I think if there's one event that goes above and beyond for its players, it's this one. There seems to be an extra feel of something, you know, special at the Travelers Championship.
Well, they do have the umbrella that is red as their logo, but it seems like this tournament rolls out the red carpet for these players. It comes off the heels of a major, so most of these players are looking for a little bit of a decompression mode for a few days, and they get it here. It's just one of these golf courses that it's right in front of you. It poses some difficulty, but in all reality, it's not overly difficult. You know, you do have to hit some proper shots here and there, but it seems awfully simple compared to what they had to face last week. So when they get here to TPC River Highlands, they're in a different kind of mode. Like, they're relaxed. They're looking at making birdies finally, because they didn't make any last week. And they're trying to just get into a really nice rhythm and kind of out of what they experienced the week before.
Currently at minus three for the round. The par 4 seventh, just under 450 yards in length, Rich. Two just accurate shots needed here.
Just a straightaway drive and a straightaway second shot. We'll get it done 8 days a week on this hole. This second shot, though, into a green that has two tiers on it. If you're not on the correct tier in two, you're going to face a difficult putt.
Lovely effort, that. Second shot here on the seventh. That's not the outcome they were after.
Oh, a little shorty Baker on that action there.
Wow, that almost went in the hole. 3 feet to go here to the hole.
This is huge for momentum. Got to try and hold this for par.
We'll now move over to Xander Schauffele.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Wow, yeah, golf clap, really good. Let's take a look at the leaderboard. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. I really like the eighth here at TPC River Highlands. A good par three.
This is a strong par three. Water shouldn't come into play as it's some 15 yards short of the green. However, there's runoff areas both right and left that could cause some issues for these players.
Going with the 5-iron here. And he's safely on the green. What are we looking at for this putt, Henny?
This one will run uphill.
This has eyes for the hole. This putt of about 6 feet coming up.
This is important. Big par putt here. It's looking solid.
Okay, steady now. Yeah, well hold. Let's move on to the next. At minus two, going along nicely today.
Not much happening. Moving down the leaderboard, never a good sign.
The ninth is a par four, right on 400 yards, Rich. But recently, players have been a little bit more aggressive off the tee.
Players are trying to take all the bunkers in the fairway out of play by taking driver and hitting it over the right-hand one. From there, players will have a very simple second shot to a green that's fairly bland, Luke. There's just not much to it. This is a great birdie opportunity.
He seems to have all the wind in his sails and maximum confidence out today against Xander Schauffele. I think Xander didn't really know what he was getting himself in for after that shot.
Lovely moment here. Good opportunity to move into a tie for third. That's a good way to bounce back from the drop shot at the last hole. And that puts him into the top five for the tournament. And Rich, we're heading into the back nine now, but I'm still thinking about that ace on the front. What a beauty that was.
Unreal. I gotta say, to watch that ball go into the hole was awesome. This player is still flying high.
Well, that's a handy shot. Sitting at three under par. Currently tied for third position. Going with the six iron here. That might be one club too many. Okay, that'll work. And this putt is for birdie three on the scorecard. Don't want to state the obvious, Rich, but a little too hard, that one. An opportunity to make a par here.
This really looks good.
That'll affect the scorecard. Well, that hole's behind us. More to play. Now heading over to Xander Schauffele.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
And a little slide down the standings after that hole. Downhill par threes, Rich. Lots of fun to play, particularly when it's only a wedge.
Yes, but be careful from the wind. This green is surrounded by large trees, and that wind can really swirl around this green. It's a good opportunity to make birdie, but bogeys might happen if you're not careful.
That was special. 6 feet remaining to the cup. I don't mind the look of this. That putt went a bit long there. Oh, I don't mind this par putt. Well done. Managing to maintain their position on the leaderboard.
I gotta solidify those holes, man. That was mine for the taking, for real. Jeez.
Rich, the 12th, the par four, measuring just over 400 yards. How do you play it?
Grip it and rip it. Those fairway bunkers down the right-hand side, they're really not a big bother, so try and take those on as best you can. The further you drive it down there, your second shot becomes so much easier as this green is perched above you. Again, another good birdie opportunity here.
This one looks to be headed towards the fairway. Time for the second shot at the 12th. This one could take a little bounce to the left. Well, you're a ball striker. There's no doubt about that.
Dare I say, Luke, this player has been in fuego with his approach shots. Another green in regulation.
This putt to move into a tie for first.
Starts off on a good line.
Nice one. Fourth birdie of the day. And that will take him to three under. And with that hole, this player is currently tied for first with Brooke Henderson. Well, birdies, it'd certainly be on the mind of the players when they stand on the tee at the par 5 13th, Rich. But there are bogeys here as well if you're not careful.
Don't get careless with this tee shot. Don't avoid the water on the right and try and hit it down the left-hand side, because out of bounds comes in quickly just left of those fairway bunkers. From the fairway, you have to decide where you want to go for it or lay it up out to the right. Any shots missed out to the right will leave a delicate chip to a green that runs away from the player towards the water.
Pay attention, folks. That's how you play golf. Just take a look at this one, Rich. Do you think it's makeable?
Look, I got to say, I'm really not liking their chances here, but you never know. Stranger things have happened.
We'll now move over to Xander Schauffele.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Here's Xander Schauffele. Oh, that one just missed the hole. Beautiful shot.
And this is why you got to keep your foot on the gas at all times. These guys and girls are good.
Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. Let's head to the 14th, Rich. A short par four, but you've got to hit your tee shot up the hill.
Up the hill, dogleg from right to left, but one of the most generous fairways on this golf course, if not the most generous. Anything up to the right-hand side will open up the second shot to the green that sits well below you. Any tee shots missed over to the left, however, you could have some tree issues.
Playing this shot from 120 yards. Currently in the lead by a shot. Tidy looking shot, that one. A wonderful shot into 14. It sets up another look at birdie. Just 3 feet to go to the hole. Don't miss this. They can be costly. And still in top spot after that hole. Keep it going. Well, Rich, as we approach the closing holes here at TPC River Highlands, there are some significant shots to hit. And here at 15, it's certainly one of them.
Tee shot is most definitely an important shot. If you hit a little bit too far left, water scary close to the left-hand side. Out to the right is no good. Length isn't nearly as important as how straight you can drive it.
All in all, a very exciting short par four.
Love this hole.
Now heading over to Xander Schauffele.
Coming off a bogey on the last hole.
Trying to get to 8 under par with this putt.
A great opportunity here. This for eagle.
That's disappointing. It's just about 3 feet away.
This for a birdie run.
And that putt will drop. And he'll extend his lead.
And with just a slim lead with four holes to go, do they have what it takes to get the job done?
The final par three at TPC River Highlands certainly brings a lot of elements into play.
Multiple tiers on this green. If you find the right tier, you have a good birdie opportunity. But if you hit a wayward shot, both right, left, long, or let's face it, short, you're in a bad spot.
Opting for the 6-iron. This one's going right at the pin here. Oh, that's outstanding. Another great shot by our leader.
Another green in regulation. This is an absolute clinic.
What an opportunity to make a birdie. This one started out on a good line. And that's for birdie. Well hold. And that will take him to 8 under. Currently in first position.
Two holes to go, Luke. Can they hang on? Let's find out.
Well, this lake that is a real feature here in the closing holes of TPC River Highlands. Comes into play also off the tee at 17.
The most intimidating shot on the golf course, the tee shot here at 17. Bail left, you could find the bunkers, and if you bail right, you better bring your waders.
Yeah, this is a quality looking shot, this one. That should find the short stuff. Oh, what a shot by our leader.
Simply amazing power on that tee shot.
Around 110 yards to go. Now a three-shot lead over the field. Opting for the 9-iron. That approach didn't seem to fit their eye.
And what a rare miss today. They've been so good with their approach shots.
Let's catch up with the current proceedings. This would be a great up and down. That's a wonderfully played chip shot there.
Just eyeballing that one, trying to make it.
Leading by three strokes now. The finishing hole at TPC River Highlands has gone through a few adjustments over the last handful of years, and it's also seen a very significant moment in the history of the PGA Tour.
Plenty of fantastic moments here. Tee shot goes back up the hill, over a rise, semi-blind tee shot, find the fairway, and you're going to have an excellent look at the green and a possibility of making birdie.
It was the site of the lowest ever round recorded on the PGA Tour, a 58, if you don't mind. Oh, that's piped. That's heading down the runway. Playing from around 150 yards here. Currently leading by three. Going with the 9-iron, I think. This looks to be hit pretty well from where I'm standing. Oh, that's a great approach shot. And this is why they put in hours and hours of practice. A putt to win it all.
These are on.
Now it's a tremendous performance around TPC River Highlands. The most birdies made, and they are your Travelers Championship winner.
And an outstanding win for this player, capturing the Travelers Championship. Hats off to him.
And Henny, that was some impressive play. To take down a rival of that caliber and to win the event, what a performance.
Yes, Luke, no one could catch this player, let alone their rival.
Well, another great day of action here at 2K Sports. On behalf of Rich Beam, the entire hardworking folks and team here, I'm Luke Elvey. We look forward to your company next time.
Y'all appreciate the follow, Balduff Gaming. Got you, bruh.
Sports and the PGA Tour proud to bring you the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. We're at the John Deere Classic. Today's coverage is about to begin. Delighted to have 2002 PGA Championship winner Rich Beam in the booth. I'm Luke Elvey, and it's a good morning to Henny Koyak, who's out on the course following our featured group.
Thank you, Luke. What a lovely introduction, and what a lovely day. I'm very much looking forward to strolling the fairways alongside these two players. They have been at each other, let me tell you. There's been a little bit of banter on social media back and forth in the lead up to this match. They have a bone to pick. They have a bee in their bonnet, and it's all going to be settled out on this golf course today.
No, filled with talent is Lexi Thompson. This is going to be a tight tussle. I can't wait to see how this one plays out. This one looks to be heading for the sanctuary of the fairway.
Well, Luke, you're right. He did find grass, but it's not the closely mown grass.
Looks to have opted for the 8-iron.
Oh, I didn't see this as possible. What a shot.
Henny, you've had the chance to have a look over this one?
Setting up this putt 25 feet from the cup. What a great opportunity here for a look at a birdie.
Oh, what a great stroke. And that should secure the par on this one. Here we are at the second tee.
You want to cut the corner as much as possible to shorten your second shot on this par five. Should you do that, a very straightforward second shot will set up birdies and eagles all day long. Find the trouble off the tee, and you'll find trouble on the rest of the hole. Don't fool yourself.
The second hole of TPC Deer Run, Rich, really gettable for the players.
Most players will go for this green in two. Luke, knock it on, can easily make birdie, maybe an eagle. Get a little careless, missing to the left or the right from the green. Pars and bogeys are had as well.
Opting for the five wood. I know it hasn't come up exactly how they imagine in their mind, Rich, but you've got to like that play.
It was going to take a mighty wallop to get there, but in a good position.
How close was that to going in the hole? Great shot. He has about 14 feet to the hole. This is a good chance. Appears to have overcooked this one. A par putt awaits. Oh, what a stroke. Yeah, nice to make a mid-range par putt. Let's take a look at Lexi Thompson, shall we?
It's been so tight. She's tied here with her rival. And can she pull ahead now?
Let's take a look at the current standings. So, no movement on the leaderboard there, remaining at even overall. Here we are in front of a par three.
Par three, 183 yards up the hill, blind tee shot. The big miss here is short right in that deep bunker. Should you find that bunker, you're also going to find yourself making bogey or worse. Anywhere on the green is a good shot. This needs to go a little bit right once it lands.
Yeah, the wind's really starting to blow, but that didn't faze them.
7 feet to the cup. Nice stroke. That's a great play at a great time, because they've not only moved up the leaderboard, they've now moved one shot in front of their rival. And this player's moving up on the leaderboard after that hole. And they'd be feeling buoyed with confidence after that birdie. Here's a good chance to maintain the momentum.
Par four, 448 yards, sweeping dogleg left to right, big tree in the middle, missed that, and you've got a simple second shot into a sliver of a green. Days a week, that rhythm works.
And he's down there.
This is down breeze, so it's going to be tough to stop it on this green.
That's a good shot by him. He'll be delighted.
This one here, this is for back-to-back birdies, moving him in the right direction.
And back to the course with the live action. Scorecard filled with threes never hurts. Good putt to make this.
I can't believe this. Is this going to go in?
Well, nicely done. Holds the putt for back-to-back birdies. Back-to-back birdies never hurt, Rich.
I like it. He's feeling it.
Trailing by a stroke after that hole. It's time to step onto the tee here at the fifth.
Par four. This fairway chases away from the players down the hill. So tee shots will run forever, setting up a second shot that is very simple and straightforward.
Oh, great swing there. TPC Deer Run, Rich, is full of forced carries, and the fifth is no different.
I love the second shot. Should you find the fairway, you have a very simple shot down the hill where you can see the entirety of the green. You will go flag hunting with your second at the fifth.
Chosen the pitching wedge here.
Club up. I like this play. Taking things up a notch in this Lexi Thompson rivalry, that shot will add some fuel to the fire.
Important putt here. They make it. They're into the top five. That was a gallant attempt. Well, this would be a good one to make. It's for par. That's a disappointing par in the end after such a terrific shot in.
Opportunity lost, and one they needed to take advantage of, sitting just two back of the lead.
He's in a share of fifth position.
Gotta like it, moving up the leaderboard, never a bad thing.
Well, That's a touch of the Freddie Couples rhythm right there. And Henny, what kind of a shot are they facing this time?
This is looking around 115 yards out.
That's a good looking shot there. Now moving over to Lexi Thompson.
Yeah, she's down, she's behind, her rival's scooting ahead. Let's see what happens.
A chance to get to three under with this putt.
Little birdie look in here.
Ouch, that hurts. And down it goes. Trailing by a couple of strokes now. Teeing off here at the seventh.
Par three down the hill. It seemingly plays short, but I can promise you it doesn't.
Like they've got the five wood. This one heading towards the green. That should set up another chance. And Henny, what are they looking at here?
They've just got to focus on hitting the back of the cup, guys. This is up the hill, bit of extra juice needed.
Was on a good line. Pretty good chance here. This one's for par. Down she goes. Let's head to the next. Let's take a look at Lexi Thompson, shall we?
She's trying to pull ahead in this group rivalry. Let's see what happens.
Oh, that's great. It just missed the hole. Ha ha, that's a beauty. She'll be stoked.
Oh, that was a tasty little morsel, wasn't it?
The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. A long par four this hole.
Par four. Every single shot plays uphill. Make sure to take plenty of club.
Time for the second shot at the eighth. And choosing the eight iron here. Oh, look at this. Right down the throat. But not a bad approach. He'll be putting.
Already had a few birdies today. This for another.
Well, this would be a good putt to make to move into the top five. Ooh, a par putt on the table. Now, that's got to be frustrating. Hit such a great approach shot in, but wasn't able to convert. Currently two under for the event. Time to take a look at what this par four might be in order.
Par four, 485 yards, the toughest hole on the golf course. Make sure you find the fairway and get your second shot somewhere around the green to give yourself the best chance of making four.
Lovely rhythm there, Rich. That's going to work every time. And what's in front of them there, Henny?
Yep, I've paced this. He's got around 195.
Looks to be going with the five iron. Good sounding strike, that one. Will that all work up on the dance floor? Could have been worse. And this putt to move into a tie for fourth place. It's got a chance. Ooh, right by the hole. Right on 4 feet. Should make this one.
Looks good.
Now moving over to Lexi Thompson.
She made bogey, gave one back on the last hole.
They're a long way from the hole here. Work to be done. Let's take a look at the leaderboard. As we make the turn, it's always good to reflect on what we've seen out there so far, Rich.
Luke, so far, it's been entertaining watching these two go head-to-head. I'm not too sure exactly how this is going to play out. So far, so good. Love watching these two compete.
Oh, that sounded absolutely flushed. Second shot here at the 10th. That's some good golf right there. Getting ready to play their third. 5 strokes behind our leader. Quality shot, that one. And as they stand over this putt, it's for a share of third spot. Oh, that had eyes for it. Lovely shot. To the top five he goes. He's currently tied for third.
Getting closer to that top spot on the leaderboard. This is getting interesting.
Teeing off here at the 11th.
Par four, 428-yard tree line hole. Difficult driving hole all the way around, but should you find the fairway, the second shot on a little plateau just above the fairway is very basic.
That's a high caliber shot. A few shots under par at the moment. Currently tied third, just a couple out of top spot. You like that, didn't you? And he's down there. You got a read?
He's looking at 20 foot. This will be a good putt to hole. Looking for another birdie here.
Oh, you know you want to.
That's a fine effort, that one. You always want to putt those ones stone dead. Let's take a look at Lexi Thompson, shall we?
She's currently trailing her rival. Let's see what happens here.
So after that effort, let's take a look at the leaderboard. And now at 3 under overall. Let's head to the 12th hole, shall we?
Par 3 plays 208 yards from the back. In saying that, this is a good birdie opportunity as the green is massive in size.
Looks to be going with a hybrid here. Should find the green. That's inside the house of opportunity. Now moving over to Lexi Thompson.
She had a bad previous hole, came off with bogey.
Let's return to live play now. 16 feet to the hole.
This is what they have left for birdie here. Rolling end over end. This putt's looking great.
Let's head to the next. Just two shots back after that hole. Welcome to this hole. It's a par four.
Par four, back up the hill, 418 yards, the widest fairway on the golf course. Avoid all those bunkers. Second shot up the hill to a narrow green that slopes off on both sides.
Not bad. What kind of shot are they facing here, Henny?
Yeah, he's got a round 125 here.
Going with the 8-iron here. Well, this one's right at the pin. A wonderful shot. A chance for birdie here on the 13th. Let's take a look at Lexi Thompson, shall we?
Coming off a bogey on the last hole.
Okay, time to return to the action. Good chance to take it even deeper here. This putt's for 4-under.
Surely it's going to.
You can mark it down. That's birdie number four today. And that will take him to 4-under. He finds himself in a share of fourth.
I tell you what, inching closer to that top spot on the leaderboard, things are definitely heating up.
Here we find ourselves on the tee of a par four.
Par four, 357 yards. Almost every player in the field will be giving it a whirl. Knock it on, and you could be rewarded with an eagle two. What kind of rhythm is that? It must be tough falling out of bed every day with a rhythm like that.
Second shot here on the 14th hole. And here we are with the third shot. And only one off the pace here. Well played.
Great touch.
He has this putt to save his par. Tiger Woods back in his familiar spot. Currently on top of things right now. The finish at TPC Deer Run is full of birdie opportunities and some low scoring to be had, Rich. This 14th hole is certainly part of that lineup.
Par four, 456 in length from the back tee. Must find the fairway off the tee shot to have any hope of finding the green in two. Large trees line the right and left-hand side of the fairway.
Rich, considering everything that's been said about the great Tiger Woods throughout his entire career, it almost seems superfluous to add anything more to it. But what that man has meant to the game and again, to people like yourself who have gone on to win major championships as well.
Yeah, I would think what Tiger has brought to the game is just he changed the perception of the game as it being kind of an old man sport, and all of a sudden he's out there winning and fist pumping and getting the crowds fired up and everybody into the game. It just kind of changed the entire complexion of it. No longer do you have these old guys that are dressed poorly with big beer bellies, and all of a sudden, you know, you got guys that are young and wearing these tight fitting clothes, going into the gym and treating it more like a business instead of just a sport. He really changed the entire dynamic of the game, the landscape of what it takes to become a great player. And, you know, everybody else was just kind of sitting there in awe going, well, how does he do this? Well, it's almost like he had a plan, a master plan to go out there and listen, I'm going to dominate by being physically better, mentally better, and I'm just going to steamroll these guys. And when he first started doing that, everybody's kind of looking back going, okay, he's taking this seriously. Maybe I need to start taking it seriously too, right? So it's just one of those things that came along that nobody knew what to really expect of him. But he told us right away, listen, I expect to win every single week out there. And sure enough, that's what he did.
Good look at a birdie here.
Short game has been absolutely fantastic today.
Looking really good, this one. Oh, what an excellent time to make a big putt like that. And you bet their rival knows just what happened. And after that hole, the standings have this player in second place behind Tiger Woods. This hole is a par five.
Players looking for a fast finish on the par five, 550 yards. Second shot does play up the hill, but there's plenty of room to miss your second shot around this green. Must make birdie for the players in the field.
Second shot here on the 17th hole. Getting ready to play their third. Just one shot back now. Well, this would be a good putt to make. Stay close to the leader.
One of the good guys out there, Luke. I am hoping for this one to fall.
This one has eyes for the hole. Oh, what a round this is. Seven birdies today. And that will take him to seven under. Now moving over to Lexi Thompson.
She made bogey, gave one back on the last hole.
Here's Lexi Thompson. And after that effort, that's how it looks. If you want to win a TPC Deer Run, you've got to successfully navigate this challenging final hole.
Hard to describe the difficulty of this tee shot unless you've actually been here. Par 4, 463 yards. Missed the fairway bunker down the right-hand side, and you've got a clear shot to a very narrow green surrounded by water on the left-hand side. Pretty good shot there.
Lining up here after a bunch of birdies, Rich.
Oh, what a way to finish the day. Hoping he can close out.
Going with the pitching wedge here. Nice shot, that. That should find the surface. That's an absolute ripper. What a shot. And here we have a putt to win the John Deere Classic. Good looking putt. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for your John Deere Classic winner?
What a spectacular performance all week long by this player. Clutch performance, clutch win by this player.
And wow, what a rivalry that was. Let's recap some of the results. Well done, Henny Koyak. Thanks for joining us on course today.
Thank you, Luke. The pleasure was all mine. I got to see some incredible shots and some not so good stuff, but what a day.
Well, that'll just about do it. On behalf of Rich Beam, I'm Luke Elvey. Thanks for tuning in. Look forward to your company next time.
That was a good win. That was a definite good win. I'm proud of that win. We that was a grind. We got that one out of the trenches, man, for real. I'm proud of that.
Sports and the PGA Tour are delighted to bring you the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the Genesis Scottish Open is about to kick off. I'm Luke Elvey, alongside Rich Beam in the booth, and out on the course following our feature group is the delightful Henny Quack. Hello, Henny.
Hey guys, I can't wait to watch these two go at it again. It was an incredible battle first time round, and I think there'll be a few shots fired out here.
Well, I'm certainly looking forward to following along with this rivalry. Can't wait to see what sort of excitement these two will generate. Was wonderfully done. And what are we looking at with their approach shot, Rich?
Green sits slightly above the players. There's bunkers dotting the front left and one just front right. If they do throw it to the left and long, it will come down a pretty good sized slope back onto the center of the green.
Come on, get down. That's just inside the range.
What's in front of them, Henny, with this putt?
This one's 13 feet from the cup.
This one's looking good.
Putting for par. Well, that's a no-fuss par to get the round underway, Rich.
Very nice par indeed. Very solid hole played.
And a very familiar sight. Tiger Woods on top of the leaderboard.
And as we head to the second, Rich, the players heading back towards the first tee.
Strong par four here, just under 500 yards. There's a bunker down the left-hand side you must avoid if you want a clear opening for your second shot. Narrow fairway up there. A good tee shot's a must.
And Rich, we talked about so much and we heard so many of them throughout the years. A Tiger roar just sounded different to any other roar on the golf course. Explain just the energy of that and what you endured.
Well, the Tiger roar is usually involved about 35,000 folks, and any other roar was about 3,500. So that was already a massive difference. You just knew it. There's just an energy in the air. When you heard a roar go up, you immediately could tell whether it was Tiger or it was somebody else. And it all kind of depends on how you were affected by it. And I think that where a lot of players got into trouble was listening for the roars and listening what kind of roar it was. And when they let it into their head that it was a Tiger roar, then I need to do something better. I need to change it up real quick. And in fact, that's probably what hurt them more than anything else. But listen, when Tiger did something fantastic, everybody on the golf course knew it was him.
Now, great rhythm on that swing. Rich, I know you've got terrific history in Europe. You've spent plenty of time over here. You've been revered by the European Tour. You broadcast to a European audience. How special is it for you to be here at the Scottish Open this week?
I absolutely love being back at the Scottish Open, Luke. Not only because of the venue, because of the fans and the game. They're so knowledgeable. You hit a shot to 30 feet, and you hear all sorts of people hooting and hollering because they know how good of a shot that was. I mean, I had a bad angle coming out of a rough lie, whatever it is. I just love it coming back here because it seems like they have a interest, a knowledge, and a passion for the game, unlike almost any fans around the world. I think that being in Scotland, playing over here, and having to use your imagination, hitting all the shots that are required to play well over in Scotland is imperative. And I think this is why Americans love to come over here, because it's a completely different kind of golf than what they're used to back in the U.S.
The putt drops, and that's back-to-back birdies.
Two in a row there, Luke, getting their groove on.
Solid play finds that player moving up the leaderboard after that hole. And as we take a look at the fourth hole, the shortest par four, Rich.
Yes, just around the 415-yard mark. Players who take out driver and drive it up into the narrow section of the fairway will get a really good look with their second shots. Not really what they were hoping for there.
Still a chance to attack this hole from the first cut. Looks to be going with the 6-iron.
Got great connection here. Yeah, this is looking good. That lie was just nasty. That's the best they could do from there.
Yeah, that's a top little chip shot, that one.
You better believe it is great stuff to watch.
And this effort by Justin Thomas.
He's 2 strokes behind his rival this week.
And after that effort, let's take a look at how it stands. Our current leader is enjoying a 1-shot lead. The fifth hole, Rich, a really good risk-reward short four.
Most players, Luke, should go for this short par four, but watch out for the green because this green has got all kinds of danger on it. Twist, turns, bobs, weaves, ducks, it's got it all. Nicely done.
And here we are with the third shot. 1 stroke off the lead. Oh, I like the look of that shot there, Beamer.
Judging it beautifully.
Now let's switch our focus to Justin Thomas.
Yeah, he needs to press on that gas pedal. He's 2 strokes back from his rival.
Oh, I thought that one was going in. Beauty of a chip shot there.
Yes, very smooth tempo there on that chip.
Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. And the first of our short holes here at the Renaissance Club, Rich, is the par 3-6th.
Ooh, this is a nasty little par 3 dotted by some pot bunkers on the front part of it. A big one over there on the right-hand side. Club selection is imperative.
Looks to have opted for the 8-iron.
Oh, this is on a fantastic line. Is it the right distance?
It's just about 3 feet away. And that puddle drop. Well done. And with that, he'll move to 3 under par. And after that performance, they'll stay right where they are in the standings. And the 7th on the card, Rich, our 2nd of the opening 9 par 5s.
Yeah, look, a fairly generous driving area. There's just a couple of bunkers you have to worry about. However, you find the fairway, now your chances of making birdie or better increase significantly.
Well, that's a tremendous shot and sets up a wonderful opportunity.
Always like the aggressive play, going for it in two and getting rewarded for it.
Oh, so close. A lot on the line here. This putt for a share of top spot. Now let's head over and see what JT's been doing.
Yeah, he just made bogey on that last one.
So after that effort, let's take a look at the leaderboard. And now 4 under for the day.
And after that good play, moving up the leaderboard.
Rich, as we face the eighth hole, what kind of decisions do the players face off the tee?
Well, most players aren't able to carry those fairway bunkers basically right in the middle of the fairway, so they have to lay up with a 3-wood or less, find the fairway that cambers pretty significantly from left to right.
Attaboy, good shot. This one from about 160 yards out.
Currently tied for the lead.
And choosing the 8-iron here. Well, they'd love a little bounce to the right here. Well, that's well played into birdie range here at the 8th.
And a fantastic look upcoming.
This is tracking right into the front of this cup.
Yeah, they're good momentum makers, those ones. Good putt for birdie.
And that will take him to 5-under. And with that, he's now broken the tie, all alone at the top of the leaderboard. The 9th is a strong par 3, Rich, one of the longer ones.
It is. There's some bunkers on the right-hand side that you absolutely must avoid. If you miss it on the left-hand side, however, you've got a pitch uphill to a green that will slope away from you. A par here is a really good score.
Going with the 5-wood. Oh, that's well played. And a chance for birdie here at the 9th. Oh, that's frustrating. Just 3 feet to the cup. Job done. Let's head to the next. And this effort by Justin Thomas.
He's just coming off a drop shot on that last hole.
It's time to check on the leaderboard.
He's currently in the second position. As we begin the second nine, Rich, the back nine starts with a par five.
And a par five that players should be looking to take advantage of. Just tee it up and hit it as hard as you can. Fairway is wide open. Does camber from right to left, so don't get too frisky down that left-hand side. No harm, no foul there with that shot.
I love that. Had the confidence to stand up there and try and drive the green and delivered.
I love the aggressive play, especially with being one shot back. This sets up an eagle opportunity.
Yeah, that looked to be a bit of a misread.
A chance to move into first here with this putt.
Right over the spot they were looking at.
Oh, what a super shot. Step aside, everyone else. Now number one.
Now let's switch our focus to Justin Thomas.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
Well, that's a good move. Always nice when you can head to the top of the leaderboard. Rich, I know this next hole is one of your favorites, the 11th here at the Renaissance Club.
This is one of the coolest holes I've ever played, Luke. It's a dogleg from left to right, fairly generous teeing area. Don't want to miss it too far right, however. But the second shot into this green, this could be the coolest green I've ever seen. It's got more movement than any other green I've seen in competition. I absolutely love this hole.
Oh, I could watch that swing all day. That's beautiful.
sitting at 6 under for the day. Outright first here. Opting for the 5 iron. Anywhere up on that dance floor would be nice.
Justin Thomas, who? He looks like he's having an absolute blast out there today. That was a fantastic shot into this green.
An opportunity for a birdie here.
This one's tracking.
And mark it down. That's birdie number 7 on the scorecard. And with that, he'll move to 7 under. Incredible. Still in the lead now after that hole. The 12th, Rich, par 3, just over 200 yards on the card.
You back uphill just a little bit. What really makes this hole difficult, Luke, though, is when the wind is coming directly in the player's face. When that happens, ooh, watch out. This hole is a doozy.
Going with the 6 iron here. Now let's head over and see what JT's been doing.
Coming off a bogey on the last hole.
Going with the 8 iron here. Sitting at 7 under. Currently in top spot. A wonderfully played chip shot.
Such soft hands.
And finds himself in a share of the lead. Another beautiful hole, Rich. This one right along the coast, the 13th.
Oh, this is breathtaking off the tee, isn't it? But don't let the views suck you in. Even though it's a wide fairway, you got to hit it down the right-hand side as this fairway pitches significantly from right to left. Find the fairway. And happy days.
And what are we looking at here, Henny?
He's got roughly 105 yards here.
Oh, this one's right down the pipe. Wow, what a shot.
Luke, nothing gets past you. Yes, this kid is a stud.
This one's for birdie. On a great line. Well, what a performance. 8 birdies on the card. And with that, he'll move to 8 under par. Awesome play. And this effort by Justin Thomas.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Well, this one's going right at the flag. Oh, that one's absolutely stiff. And let's see what that shot did to the leaderboard. And after a birdie at the last, they take the honor on the hole.
a sweet looking swing, that one. That's a wonderful shot here at the 14th. It sets up a chance for birdie.
Of all the shots that I like the most, that one ranks right up there.
And down it goes.
Back-to-back birdies moving the right direction there, Luke.
The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. And coming off the birdie, they'll be proud of themselves, a chance to keep it rolling. That drive, heading straight towards the cut stuff. And Henny, what's he facing with this one?
Setting up here from about 165 yards.
Not the result they were after there.
Missing it short there, they will definitely be upset.
That's a well-played chip shot there.
Just eyeballing that one, trying to make it.
Now let's switch our focus to Justin Thomas.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead.
Three holes remaining, folks.
I'm really just kicking it, watching the play in while, you know, kicking it with y'all, but I definitely should have more. I still got to do a lot of work with learning the putt and learning the green, man, because I've given away a bunch of holes that I shouldn't have.
And you got to believe you're going to make, at worst, a birdie four.
Awesome stuff.
Playing from around 210 yards here. He leads the field by a stroke. Going with the 5-iron here. Well, you can see why he's leading. That was a shot of high caliber. And 11 under in front of the player with this putt.
A chance to get two back on the course here, this one for Eagle.
Not sure if they understood the lie of the land there, Rich. Just a 4-footer remaining. Ooh, nice putt to make for a birdie. Currently 3 strokes up after that hole.
2 holes to go, Luke. I know who I like.
All right, Rich, the 17th.
This is an amphitheater-style green. All sides kind of work back towards the green. There is a little front left section, though. When they put the flag stick over there, you have a really good opportunity to hit it in there close.
Looks to be going with the 5-iron. Well, good looking shot here. That's headed towards the green. That was a beauty.
And this one for back-to-back birdies.
Like the look of this one. Just hammered that through the line. Par putt coming up here. This one's looking good. That gets the job done. Now let's head over and see what JT's been doing.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Opting for the 5-iron. And after that effort, this is how the leaderboard looks. Our leader is enjoying a 3-stroke advantage. And as we make our way to the finishing hole here, Rich, how is this 18th at the Renaissance Club?
This is an absolute brute, Luke. Just under 500 yards, and you must find the fairway. You cannot geek it down this hole off the tee. There is danger both left and right.
And Henny, what's he looking at here?
I'd say he's about 165 from this flag.
Looks to have opted for the 8-iron.
Oh, this needs a little right turn, Clyde.
Well, that's beautifully judged. All right, let's keep the focus here. This is to win the event. This one's tracking. And this historic tournament has yet another champion. Congratulations to our Genesis Scottish Open winner.
And what a victory it was around this Renaissance Club here in Scotland. An impressive victory by this player.
Well, they came, they saw, and they conquered. They took down a fierce rival, and that's a victory they should be proud of, Henny.
Oh, absolutely. They silenced the giant today. They got the job done against the odds. We shouldn't ever have doubted them. There was some spectacular golf out there, and it was a pleasure to watch.
Well, that just about concludes our coverage. On behalf of Rich Beam, I'm Luke Helvey. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you tomorrow.
Sports, in association with the PGA Tour, is proud to bring you the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the Royal Championship is about to begin. I'm Luke Olvey alongside Rich Beam in the booth, and it's a hello to Henny Koyak down on the course following our featured group.
Hey guys, yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing these two go at it again. It was a great rivalry first time round, and now, more so than ever, they're going to want to beat each other.
Well, it's certainly a great opportunity for this player to bounce back in this rivalry. Can't wait to see what sort of excitement that these two generate. Looks to be a fairway finder to me. Playing from 110 yards out. Choosing the 9-iron here. Now, yeah, good safe shot this one. That should find the surface. A wonderful shot and a chance for birdie here on the first. Hey, nice looking line. Well, that'll play.
Can't birdie them all unless you birdie the first, Luke. Good start.
Currently one under for the tournament. Well, now let's see if we can get some more insight on this week's venue. John, what have you been seeing here at Lachlan Crossing that players may want to keep their mind on this week?
Well, Luke, one thing I've been seeing is a lot of excitement in the crowd. People love when the PGA Tour comes to Scotland. And if you open your eyes, you can see why. This is a classic Scottish links layout. Giant fairways and greens. And some of these greens are shared greens, so a couple holes using the same green, which is kind of a hallmark of some of these old Scottish courses. These links fairways are rugged, to say the least. Hard to tell where some of these shots will end up after they come off the club face because of the undulation in the fairways. One other thing to be aware of is the pot bunkers. There are some really small ones out there as well, and they can be very sneaky. You never know where they might pop up. Luke, I love being in Scotland. Love breathing in that crisp Atlantic air. Can't wait to see what happens on the course this week.
Yeah, good swing. This one's heading up onto the green for sure. And he's hit that inside the range. And now we can take a look at how that play affects the leaderboard. Welcome to the tee of a par four. Looks like this one's heading safely for the fairway. This shot is about 140 yards out. Opting for the 9-iron.
Clubbing up, smart. Got to control it though. Let's see. I think he's got playing partner Colin Morikawa looking a little nervous after that shot.
Putting for birdie.
Looking good so far.
Yeah, nice mid-range birdie putt that one. And with that hole behind them, this player is currently tied for first with Lexi Thompson. Looking
looking to ride the momentum after coming off a birdie here with this shot.
Good shot there. It's a fairway finder for sure. Playing from around 240 yards. He shares top spot.
Well played.
Already had a few birdies today. Another opportunity for another one. Let's take a look.
Let's take a look at Colin Morikawa.
Let's get back to it, shall we? Trying to get to 3 under par with this putt.
He's staring down a birdie putt here.
Is on a great line.
Okay, steady now.
Putting for a par now.
Just one off the lead after that hole. Time to face a par four. Beautiful swing there.
Henny, do you have a better look at this lie?
This is what bad luck looks like. Just off the fairway, but sitting really down.
Setting up from the first cut here in the green.
Well done. That takes the pressure off the putt. That's a chip to be proud of.
Great touch.
Now over to Colin Morikawa.
Who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
Just didn't drop. Didn't quite have the right stuff there. And after that effort, this is how the field is shaping up. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. Here we are at Lachlan Crossing. The sixth hole is one of those par fives. It just feels like it's a tad too far to reach into.
It is, especially when it's going into the prevailing wind, which is how this hole was designed. Go ahead and just bail out to the right. Avoid those bunkers completely. Then you're going to go ahead and lay up once again out to the right-hand side. Don't challenge the bunkers. It's not worth it. Not unless you know for a fact you can get on in two. From there, you're going to have a nice, simple pick shot from, oh, I don't know, 80, 90, 100 yards to a green. Fairly undulating, but still just begging to be birdied.
Handy effort, that one. Time for the second shot here at the sixth. Yeah, this is the stuff we love, getting after this par five and two.
I'll tell you what a sensational play. This player stepped up their game, a bold play, hopefully a bold reward.
A bit too much pace on that one. What's in front of them, Henny?
Firm, back, up the hill. This will be a good one.
Get excited, this could go in. Super shot that, and that will take him to 3 under. So no change on the leaderboard for this player after that hole. Let's Let's see what happens here on the seventh.
They've chosen to club down on this one.
That's right out of the copybooks. Exquisite.
Gotta like their chances from there.
And back to the play, shall we? This putt is about 8 feet.
This for back-to-back birdies.
Oh, just missed. And just a little bit of cleanup work remaining on this hole. Currently at -3 for the event. We've reached the eighth hole. Oh, that was pure. Playing this shot from around 120 yards. Just one stroke back in this tournament. Well, it's fair to say that that approach didn't hit the mark.
Coming up a little short with that effort. Not bad, though.
Chance to save the par if he can make this one. Not a bad line, this. Ouch, that hurts. And this one will be for bogey. Trailing by a couple of strokes now. Teeing off now on the ninth hole. Oh, you couldn't paint a better picture. Gorgeous swing. All right, Henny. What's he got in front of him here with this putt?
This is downhill. Can't be too bold.
Go on. Get in the hole. And with that, that's their fourth birdie. And with that, we'll move to 3 under par. He's currently just in second place. I'm pretty sure this player will be buoyed by that birdie back at the last. Let's see if they can deliver another one. Yeah, you hit a beauty, didn't you? Time for the second shot at the 10th. Going with a 3-wood here. That's disappointing. Getting ready to play their third. And just one shot off the lead. Didn't that look good for a long time? Well, I hope he makes this one. It's for par. Need to pull the putter back a little bit further, I think.
Wow. Shocking to say the least. How do you miss that?
Now let's switch our focus to Colin Morikawa.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
And after that effort, this is how the leaderboard looks right now. Our current leader is enjoying a two-stroke lead. The 11th hole at Lachlan Crossing is a strong par 4, 470 plus yards from the back tees, and there's plenty to contend with, Rich.
Luke, just that one menacing bunker right in the middle of the fairway that's going to drive you crazy as a player. However, you miss it, now you got a second shot with, funny enough, no bunkers on the green. It's got a lot of undulation to it, especially on the front right part of it, so you can't afford to miss it there. Anything missing out to the left, though? Just fine, my friend.
Going with the 5-iron here. Well, that's comfortably on the dance floor. Well played. Now, a quality shot from him. He'll be pleased. What have they got in front of them here, Henny?
This is about 24 feet for him here. This is their look at birdie.
That'll sting a bit. 3 feet to go here to the hole.
Putt is underway.
Currently a couple under for the event. Now teeing off on the 12th hole. Wonderfully played. Second shot here on the 12th. That's a terrific shot and sets up a birdie opportunity here at the 12th. Now, this is a challenging one. A lengthy putt awaits. Okay, let's get back to the action. It's just about 3 feet away. And racking up their fifth birdie of the day. And that will take him to 3 under. Some lovely momentum for this player, moving up the leaderboard. Lovely momentum for this player after that birdie at the last hole. Keep it rolling. Good shot there, Beamer. Second shot here on the 13th. No point hanging on to that one. You didn't hit your best there. Well, I know that we're in the booth and not right up close to it, but it doesn't take a smart person to work out. That's not a nice lie.
Hitting it over here in the first place was just awful. I would blame his caddy.
Oh, almost went in. Sitting at -3. Currently tied atop the leaderboard. Oh, wouldn't that have been nice? He's got a par putt here. Let's see if he can make it. Looking really good, this one. Was on a good line. Just a tiny putt is all that remains. He's in a share of third place.
Midway through the closing nine here at Lachlan Crossing. This 14th hole is a par four over 450 yards.
Once again, Luke, just another gem of a hole. Massive bunker out there in the center of the fairway. But for most players, it's not going to come into play. Anything down just the right-hand side of this fairway is ideally placed. The second shot, clear. Oh, I don't know. A lot of beach there to a green that's probably got more undulation than any other one on this golf course. A massive green, lots of opportunities to do good, but also a lot of opportunities to do some bad.
Shot almost went in the bucket. Now over to Colin Morikawa.
Yeah, he just made bogey on that last one.
Gee, that'll keep the momentum rolling. Rich
needed it, needed that in a big way, chipping in for the par.
This putt will move them to 3 under par. That's too bad.
It's a lot slower going up the hill than what this player read.
Big putt for par coming up. Currently a couple under for the round. We've arrived at a par four hole.
Really hoping they play this one aggressively.
Now let's switch our focus to Colin Morikawa.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
How close was that to going down? That's a high quality recovery shot.
Gotta say, his short game is phenomenal.
Time for the second shot at the 15th. A couple under at this stage, currently tied for third. Yes! Hold it! And that will move him up the leaderboard as well. Oh, that was a touch of class. Wouldn't mind seeing that again.
Oh yeah, look at those hands. What a chip shot.
Just two shots back after that hole. We have a par three on this one. And choosing the 8-iron here. Let's finish with a flurry. It'd be nice to make a move up the leaderboard. Yes, anytime you can find the green and have a putt, you'll take it. Always love these opportunities, especially when it's for birdie.
I really hope this one drops for him.
Now that's how you roll the rock.
Ooh. You finished your work on that hole. Let's take a look at the next one.
Now over to Colin Morikawa.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. Let's see what happens here at the 17th.
That swing reminded me of smooth jazz. Great rhythm.
Opting for the 5-wood. Well played. What a good opportunity you've got here. Let's hold it.
Always rooting for this player, Luke. I hope this one goes. Looking better.
Oh, what a round this is. 7 birdies today. And with that, he'll move to 4 under par. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead.
Managing to chase down the leaders, closing that gap. Gotta like it.
And as this player tees off on their final hole, they're one shot off the lead. The look of the line here, it should find the fairway. Well, they need to stick this close. A birdie would tie them for the lead and force a playoff. Well, that certainly makes putting a lot easier when you can hit a shot like that.
Looking for back-to-back birdies here, Luke.
And this putt is for a final score of 65. Well, how about that, Rich? We're going to extra holes now. Here we go, Rich. It's time for a playoff, and we'll be using the aggregate format for this one.
Luke, in playoffs, anything can happen, my friend. Let's sit back and watch.
Well, here we go. Two players remain. Glory awaits.
Let's get this playoff going.
Wow, I didn't even know they had this power. Great drive.
Well, what's your advice here, Rich, with the opponent so close to the hole?
Only look at the flag stick, look at nothing else. Hit your shot and hit it close.
Ooh, there's still some work to be done here. The pressure of the playoff starting to show on this player. Feet to the cup coming up. Well, that's a nice line. Hopefully this putt drops. This hole will set them back a bit, but there's still time to recover. And now onto the next hole of this playoff. And now teeing off on this par 4 hole.
Look, both players have played this hole under par this week, so no advantage here in the playoff.
This is a good time to get hot with the tournament on the line. Second shot here on the 17th.
opting for the hybrid, I think. A wonderful shot and a chance for birdie here on the 17th. Ooh, these are good for the momentum, these ones, right on 8 feet.
One of the good guys out there, Luke. I'm hoping for this one to fall.
Oh, gee, that line was looking good, wasn't it? It's apparent this player will be falling further behind when this putt drops. And you can feel this title just slipping away, falling further behind in this playoff. Let's take another stroll up the last, shall we? Let's head to this lengthy par four.
Luke, the player has owned their opponent score-wise on this hole. Let's see if anything changes in the playoff.
Not the ideal position to be, especially in a playoff. Plenty to play for here. Looks like you're going to need more bunker practice. That's on the green, but still a fair way from the hole. Let's see if you can make this. Keep the par on the card. And with that, this player will have to deal with the agony of defeat. Just didn't quite have enough to win this playoff. Well, Rich, they're certainly not going to be happy with that playoff result.
No, they're not. They seemingly had it all together in regulation, but during the aggregate, not so much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, hope you enjoyed our extra coverage in this week's playoff finale. From myself and all the hardworking people at 2K Sports, thanks for tuning in. See you next.
Yo, what up, Raul? How you feeling, bro? Jesus. That game mode always gets me. It's like, you know, you got to stand within the perimeters of whatever you got going on. You don't just kill, you know what I'm saying? How long you been hitting the gym, bro? I gotta get back in the gym now that you bring it up. For real. Been thinking about that. I always feel better when I leave the gym. Now getting there is a bit of a hustle, but leaving, it's always a beautiful feeling. Since November, oh, okay, cool. How much you drop, bruh? I'm doing fantastic, by the way, man. I'm living the life, living it, feeling good. Wow, wait a minute. What does he have? No way. That was horrible. That was trash. Oh, he's lagging? Hold on one sec. My man's is right there. You dropped dang game? Hey, that's a beautiful place to be, bro. Beautiful place to be. He just dropped. Hold on one sec. One sec. Oh, got him. Got my mans. Oh, got my mans, though. You just got back playing Apex? How's that been for you, man? I haven't played Apex in so long. It just, whoa. That is stopped me. That was weird. That was really weird. What? That was weird. Can I get up? Wow, I almost killed him. We're not losing by that much. I should have switched shoulders like I wanted to. I watch Apex a lot on stream, but I haven't played it at all, really. Who's your main? You still main Octane? I think that was your main last time we played. Whoa. Just lost, I guess. Yeah, just lost. Wait. What's, I don't even know. Okay, we still got our team out. It's like, usually people quit, but I was just seeing if we still had our team. Did she say embarrassing? Oh. Good sound, though. That was a good sound. I think I meant to do that. One shot, but finger slip. I don't even know what this is, to be honest. And why there's just smoke. I gotta go back in the smoke. Go back where my team is. Hit him a couple times, yo. Chappie. Who's Chappie? I can't remember who Chappie is. They're behind us? Oh. Okay. We're not losing by much, and we can win this. Let's go. Oh, he's behind us. Oh, no. We got this. Let's go. We got this.
Mission is complete. Good work.
Oh, Pathfinder. Okay. Let's go. That was a good win. I'll be right back. All right. I'm back with you. Let's do one more of this and then we'll see what we're doing. Do you have a workout partner, Raul, or you just go by yourself?
Historically, sauces are either sweet or spicy, but Arby's new King's Hawaiian Chicken Sandwich is both, because Arby's makes both history and sandwiches. Arby's, we have the meat.
Tonight's well-designed play brought to you by Etsy. You know,
Hey, man, I got to get out of here. I appreciate the time, man. I got to go.